wait.
Stepping stone,
and making it possible, of course, for the teachers, past and present, who are here, and the staff of Cape Town Collegiate. I welcome to you and thank you for all that you have done in the life of these young people. The parents and grandparents and extended family, it's a proud day for you, and you should enjoy that. And of course, most of all, the graduates. I hope and pray that God will give you the strength and courage and wisdom to make the right choices, and this will be one of many wonderful days for you. I will not be making announcements. We have a bulletin, the order of service is there, and as you see your turn, please come forward and do what is slated for you, and God bless you all.
Walk away from the best of days. Welcome everybody in the Cape John Collegiate graduating class of 2019. Congratulations to the graduates. And they're on their way. I guess parents would say, I'm glad about that. So I just want to congratulate the class and on behalf of the Pentecostal Church in Sugarbowl, wish them all the best. And may they, as they have said on their way, may they be led by the Lord and blessed and guided by the Lord and protected by the Lord. God bless you, each one.
Congratulations. They all look beautiful and handsome, don't you think not? Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, many voices are speaking to us today. The internet, concert stages, TV, cell phones, friends, our community, and families. Today, Lord, we choose to listen to your voice, to respond to your desires, to follow your highest path for us. As these voices ring in our ears, do what pleases you, Lord, and stay true to the path you have lovingly set before them. Strengthen each of us to choose the high road, to live to the greatness you have placed within us, and to honor you in all our ways. With a hopeful spirit, a steady vision, and a persistent faith, pursue God's plans for your life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Congratulations from the Salah Shemri, all C4, and pray that God will bless you on this very, very special day that you're celebrating. Let's stand for prayer, please. Oh God, our Father, and we want to tell you that you are a good God, and that you're a good, good Father. One that your word tells us that we can come to, no matter what the situation that we might find ourselves in. Sometimes, Lord, they're not great experiences. But on a day like this, we thank you for the fact that it's a very exciting day. It's a day of much joy. Maybe, though, Lord, there may be a little bit of sadness realizing that this class will now sort of split and go their different ways and become involved in the things that they have decided over the months and years that they would do in the future. It's a very exciting day in that we can share the victories and all of the good things that's happened to us and the friendships that we have made over those many years. And we pray, Father, that you would bless these graduates today, that your arms of love, blessing, will be theirs. They would experience something of your presence on this day, something of your presence with your arms around them. We pray, Father, for everything that will transpire this evening. We pray that your blessing will rest upon all of the activities, all of the things that will be said and done. We pray, Father, that you would use these things to help us understand that you love us, that you care about us, and that you are always with us, no matter where we go in life. Bless, we pray, in Christ's name. Amen.
It's an honor for Bob and I to be here representing the C Pentecostal Church. but also because three of our grandchildren have graduated here previously. We were privileged to be at each of these grads, so it's a wonderful thing to join you. A lot of your faces are becoming familiar. Congratulations to the graduating class. I am really amazed, though, that 12 teenagers could keep their voices so mellow and sweet for a choir as they did. It was beautiful. Bless you. I commend the graduates also and the teaching staff here for allowing the beginning celebrations to be held in a church, acknowledging our need of God. I really appreciate this admonition with a hopeful spirit, steady vision, a persistent faith. Let's pursue God's plans for our lives. And one of Paul's statements saying, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. It gripped me as a teenager. I'm still working with that in my life today. And so I'd like for you to stand with me and sing a song that is very fitting. To God be the glory. Let's stand together as we sing it, shall we?
To God be the glory, great things He has done. So loved He the world that He gave us His Son.
Secure. The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. Surely I have a delightful inheritance. I will praise the Lord who counsels me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With Him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure. Because you will not abandon me to the realm of the dead, nor will you let your faithful one see decay. You make known to me the path of life. You will fill me with the joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand.
I learned after the first year to take this out and turn a little bit, because I almost fell down there, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to try and turn. You going to kiss me? Good luck. All right, so this is year number 3 for me. This is graduation day for the class of 2019, and it's here. Wow, all those 13 years, and now you're here. And I bet you're saying it didn't come fast enough, right? I know. Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm letting you in on a little secret, that the days from here on out are going to go so much faster that you better not blink or you might miss them. And it was 12 years ago, not to the day, but 12 years ago, 12 graduations ago, that I sat here for my graduation from St. John Collegiate. And some of the teachers and the staff are the same crowd that's here today. Boys, you're getting old. You're getting up there now. But this is your day. This is your long-awaited graduation day. And I absolutely love that the theme that you guys have chosen for your graduation that says, chase your dreams, but always remember the road that will lead you home. I love it. It's jam-packed with meaning, and today that's what I want to use to talk to you just for a few moments. And I read this over a few times at home, and I got it nice and condensed and short so that I won't keep you too long. Because I don't remember one thing that they told me at my graduation. So you might not remember a thing I say either, but I'm going to try and keep it short so you might get some. I'm going to tell you a little story. There was this mom, and she was a doctor, and she was taking a 4-year-old girl to school. And so she had a stethoscope, she was a doctor, on the seat next to her little girl. And on the way there, the little girl started picking up and playing with it. And the mom got really excited. She said, yes, my little girl's going to follow in my footsteps. She's gonna be a doctor just like me. And the little 4-year-old takes up the instrument, looks at it, and starts speaking into it and says, hello, welcome to McDonald's. May I take your order? We all have different dreams. Your dreams are not your parents' dreams. Your parents' dreams weren't their parents' dreams. Even the people sitting next to you, your dreams are not all the same. Just as our faces look different, so are our dreams. But I want to tell you to chase your dreams. Now that's what your theme says, but I want to tell you to really do that. Now we all start out in life with all this enthusiasm and great expectations for the future. When you stood on the stage in kindergarten and they asked you what you wanted to be, you were all so excited to say a nurse, a hairdresser, a doctor, a cop, a fireman, whatever you said, you were so excited. And you thought you had the world figured out, and that's what you would be when you grew up for sure. People have dreams, they set goals to reach their destiny, but quite often life can bring circumstances that come against us. Circumstances that aren't great. Sometimes we are heading towards a goal, and failure can often blow up the flames of our life. So let me ask you a question before we go any further. You don't need to answer it in life. How is your dream today? There's a guy by the name of Dr. Abdul Khalil. You have to dream before your dreams come true. You have to dream before your dreams come true. So right from the get-go today, make sure that you stand at this pivotal point in your life and you have a clear picture of the dream. The clear picture of your dream. And then when you do, there'll be endless possibilities that lie before you. There was a study made of 200 people that were considered very successful. It was discovered that all 200 of them had one common factor. Each had dared to dream big dreams, to set goals, and to reach out to achieve those goals. Basketball superstar Michael Jordan, he was cut from his high school basketball team. However, he didn't give up. He practiced, and he committed to shooting 300 baskets every day because he didn't take his eyes off his promise, off the dream. When Thomas Edison invented the light bulb, he tried over 2,000 experiments before he got one that worked. And a young reporter asked him, how did it feel to fail so many times? He said, I never failed once. I invented the light bulb.
It just happened to be a 2,000-step process. Listen, make sure you dream and make sure you dream big. On the road to achieve your dreams, you may come across some giants that will try and rip you from the road. They're going to try and keep you from reaching your goals. First, the giant of opposition. There are going to be people out there that are going to tell you that your dreams are silly, that they'll never happen. These same individuals will do everything in their power to talk you out of reaching the goal that you had in your mind. Don't listen to them for a second. Every time you try something new, there will be those who will criticize what you're doing. Every time you explore new fields, someone is going to say, it won't work, you're foolish to even try. Don't listen to them. There's also the giant of failure. At one point or another in our lives, we've all been afraid to fail. When someone steps out on a new adventure, we all usually do so because we want to succeed. No one sets out to say, I'm going to do this so that I will fail miserably. No. We all set out with the hopes of succeeding. Whenever you plan to do something and it's new territory for you, be ready for failure, because we all fail at times, but try again. In the verse in Proverbs 24, verse 16, it says, the righteous fall 7 times, yet they rise up again. We all make mistakes. We all fail, but keep on trucking. If you're afraid of failure, then make sure to seek God in what it is that you're doing, and He will show you His ways, which is the best way. That's the way you were created to live. And even though we may fail, that does not mean that it's game over for us. Get back up. This just might be your 2,000-step process. Then there's the giant of laziness. Most people never realize their potential because guess what? Sometimes we're a little bit too lazy. These people don't work hard. You see, it's much easier just to sit and be content. But hard work leads to success. Do whatever you do with the utmost dedication and commitment. Even though you might not get the recognition for what it is you're doing, keep going. Keep doing the best and you'll see how you inch ever so closely to that dream. Proverbs 10:4 says, he who has slack hands becomes poor, but the hand of a diligent man brings wealth. If you're going to dream it, you have to be willing to work for it. Nothing worth having comes easy. In spite of all of those giants, dream big. Chase your dreams. But there's a second part of your theme, and that says, always remember the road that leads you home. We had a scripture reading that Riley read for us just a moment ago, and it talked about how the Lord had pleasures for us, and it talked about how when we're going to sleep or whatever, we can trust in Him. He'll take care of us. But verse 11, the last verse that he read, says, you make known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. God makes known to us the path of life, but in order for Him to make known to us His path, we have to ask Him. We cannot just go aimlessly through this life chasing our dreams and neglect the road that leads home. What I mean by that is we cannot go through life chasing our dreams without stopping and taking the time to make sure that our dreams align with God's plan and purpose for our lives. You have to do that. You see, there is a road, a very bumpy road, a very road that's filled with potholes that will lead you to Lassie, or Shuko, or Brinsko, or Harbor Round, or wherever it is that you're from. They'll lead you there. You may have a few bumps and bruises along the way. You may have a flat tire, but you'll get there. But the road that I want to talk about is a much more important road that leads to home with a capital H. That is home to heaven with God our Father. Matthew 7:14 says, but small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only few will find it. That's the road that you want to travel in as you chase your dreams. Well, you say, how in the world do you expect me to find a road that only a few is going to find? If only a few is going to find it, it must be hard. Remember your scripture that Riley read? It said, He will make known to you the path of life. God will show you. God will reveal it to you. But you just have to ask. Whatever the plans, the dreams, and the hopes that you have for your future, if you remember nothing else I say today, remember to never leave God out of it. A very, very familiar verse. And they use it all the time at graduations. And it's Jeremiah 29:11. It says, I know the plan I have. Lord. His plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. But I don't want to leave it there. I want to go on to the next two verses. Verses 12 and 13. And it says, then you will call on me, and you will come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. This is God. You come, you pray to him, he's going to listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all of your heart. So as you're chasing your dreams, as you're going down the path of life, whatever it is that your dreams are, God is right there, and all you have to do is seek him. And when you get overwhelmed and you don't know which way is up or down and which way to go, be assured that he's still there. And he's just a mention of thing. You've got to just pray to him, and he's going to make known to you the path of life. So while you're out there chasing your dreams, seek God in all you do, and I know beyond any doubt that he is going to take you on the journey of a lifetime. My prayer is that God would bless you, that you would seek him, and I'm going to end with this. Congratulations. Have the best day ever. Soak it all up. Enjoy it. Have some fun. Because I'm going to have some fun with you. I don't like cold plates, but I'm going to come there and eat turkey. And I don't know how to dance, I'm going to come here and watch you dance because your grand march stuff. So maybe I learn how to dance. Whatever it is, I want you guys to enjoy this, soak it up. This day is going by so fast already, I'm sure. And it's a day that would be somehow perfect to say or itched in my mind from 12 years ago. People who have graduated longer than that can remember bits and parts of their day. Take it all in. Enjoy it. We're not done school yet, so enjoy this day. Enjoy this weekend before school comes back and you got exams. I said it. Sorry. But when this day is over, when school for this year is actually over, and you actually move into the next stage of your life, remember the theme that was put before you today that you guys chose. Chase your dreams. With whatever you got, whatever is in that heart of yours that you want to be, chase it with everything you got. Hard work will pay off. But never, never forget the road that leads you home with the capital H. And that's where you find God. That's that new road. God bless you.
Well, it's my honor and privilege to bring this to a close. And for me, it's a privilege today. I didn't graduate from my school, but I left school here in 1969 to pursue my career as a Salvation Army officer. So 50 years ago, I'm back here today to participate in 2019 graduation. To me, that's a blessing in itself. Let's bow in prayer. Father, our young people sang, we've had the time of our lives, and it's only the beginning. Just the beginning. Father, we realize that there's going to be great things in store for them as they pursue their dreams, their ambitions. We know, too, that the road won't always be easy. There'll be difficult times, sad times. But, Lord, we realize that you're going to be with them. And all they had to do is to reach out to you for help and grace and strength that they need for each other. Father, we ask your blessing upon each one of the graduates, Sarah, Mandy, Riley, Tara, Chad, Annabelle, Sarah, Riley, Taylor, Ariel, Holly, and Kelsey. Father, may your presence be with them. May they sense your arms of love around about them today. And Father, we realize it's going to be difficult sometimes leaving home, but with your help, they're going to make it. They're going to reach for the stars. And you're going to be all that it should be. So, Father, bless them today. And may your arms of love be around about each one of them, especially the families that they've come from. We realize, Lord, that for them it's tears of happiness, tears of joy. But through it all, Lord, it's all in your plan. So, Father, bless them today. And now as we leave this place, Lord, we pray that the grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ will be with each and every one as they venture out in the new pathways. We pray in your name.
Yes, it is so good.
Sometimes.